Does this look white? Because if this looks white, then I have my white balance set correctly. Because this light right here is, well, I don't know what it is. It's kind of tungsten-y. So when I'm shooting video, I'm always setting a custom white balance to make sure that my colors look good. And that's what I want to talk about today. I want to show you guys why you absolutely do not want to use auto white balance when capturing video with your drone. And I also want to show you just how easy it is to set a manual white balance. So yeah, let's get going. Okay, I'm in Final Cut Pro 10 here, and that's what I use for all my video editing. And I have a chunk of footage that I shot with my Spark from this past summer. And it's a touch overexposed, but it was shot using auto white balance, and it's a really good illustration of why we don't want to use auto white balance. So I'm just going to skim through the clip here and see if you can notice the color shift. So if you can't see it, I'll cut out a chunk to make it a bit more evident and see if you can see it now. So right there, you notice the color changes. So final thing I'll do is I'll turn on my video scopes here, which breaks down the color into RGB, and pay close attention to the red channel and see what happens. So do you notice how the red channel gets boosted? So our lighting conditions haven't changed, but our color has. Well, that's auto white balance, and that's exactly why you want to avoid using it. Your color is going to be constantly shifting and changing depending on what the camera is seeing, and that just becomes a real nightmare to try and fix in post-production. So if you want the best possible footage, set a manual white balance and you're good to go. Simply, white balance is about adjusting the color to make our whites look white under different lighting. Different sources of light have very distinctive color casts. So daylight is very blue, while a candle flame or a tungsten light bulb tends to be very yellowy orange. So by adjusting the white balance, we're making sure that our colors look natural under any lighting conditions. So how do we set a manual white balance? Well, it's really quite simple. We go into our camera settings, go into the additional settings, go into white balance, and then we choose one of the presets, or we can choose the custom option if we want a little bit more control. The presets are self-explanatory. Just pick the one that best suits the type of light you're shooting in. Sunny, cloudy, incandescent, or fluorescent. Most of the time, that's going to be sunny or cloudy. So pick one of those and then look at your screen. If it looks good, well, then you're good to go. That's it. That's all you have to do. And you're guaranteed that the color is not going to fluctuate while you shoot video. It's really that easy. Probably 90% of the time, I'm shooting in either the cloudy or sunny setting. But on occasion, if I'm shooting inside or I want to influence the color a little bit, you know, make it a bit warmer or a bit cooler, I will choose the custom setting. And it's really easy to do. Just go into your white balance settings, choose custom, and then move the slider until the color is to your liking. So if you want it a bit more yellow, a bit warmer, that's fine. If you want it a bit cooler, a bit more blue, well, that's fine too. You're in charge. The key takeaway here is you just don't want the color to fluctuate. The custom white balance setting is based on color temperature, and that is commonly expressed in Kelvin. Now, maybe you've seen one of those fancy color temperature charts. Well, I have a really simple example of that here. And basically, the lower color temperature numbers are considered warmer, so more yellow and orange, and the higher color temperature numbers are considered cooler and more blue. Now, I know that seems kind of opposite to what you think. You think higher temperature, you're thinking red, orange, fire, flame. Nah, that's not the way the color temperature chart works. So if you're shooting in daylight conditions and you intentionally choose a lower color temperature number, like 3000 Kelvin or something, you're going to end up with really, really blue footage. Now, why does that happen? Well, by choosing the lower color temperature number, we're telling the camera that we're shooting in very yellow light. So in order to balance the color and get rid of that yellow color cast, it adds a whole bunch of blue. And basically, that's how white balance works. And one last thing, make sure you go into camera settings and turn on display camera OSD. That puts the little overhead display on your screen so you can see all your camera settings at a glance, and you can make sure that you're not using auto white balance. So under the WB, if you see auto, that's auto white balance. We don't want that. If you see sunny or cloudy or some number, well, that's manual white balance, and that's exactly what we want. Well, that's it for this one, guys. So just remember, if you want better looking footage, ditch the auto white balance, take that few extra seconds, go in and set a manual white balance, and your footage is gonna look better right away. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Please hit that thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and yeah, you guessed it. I will see you in the next one. Whew.